Hello and welcome to our presentation on using transitions in your WeVideo project. Please note that we are using the simple timeline editing mode, and our presentation is going to use a project that only has still images and text slides. To start with, where do you find transitions? Well, you just click on this icon that's rectangular and half shaded, and there we go. There are three categories of transitions. We have standard, patterns, and effects. And you may be wondering, well, how can I tell what the transition is going to do? How is it going to look? And when you move your cursor over a transition, you see a little play icon pop up. So just click on play, and it gives you a preview of it in your preview window. So once you've decided what transition you're going to use, we're going to go with cross blur. It's just a matter of clicking on it and dragging it down to the main editing track. Please note that you can only drop transitions onto the main editing track in simple timeline mode. And then if we want to see how that transition looks, will look in our video, we just move our playhead over to the beginning here, click on play in our preview window, and there we go. A very nice little transition there. That looks good, so we're going to select our next transition. We'll go with a wipe right, and we'll place that there, and then we'll back our playhead up a little bit so we can see how that looks with our image. And if you want your transition to last a little bit longer, I felt like that ran a little bit short, all you have to do is click and drag on the transition, and it extends the amount of time that it's going to play for. So we'll go back to our image and hit play. And that ran a little bit slower, so it lasted a little bit longer. So we'll just keep going and inserting our standard transitions here. And we'll just have a look and see how those look. That dip to black is very nice, especially if you're using it in front of a black text slide. It looks very professional. Now that we've looked at some of the standard transitions, let's look at some of the patterns. We'll look at the block pattern. That looks kind of interesting, so we'll use that next. Another thing to keep in mind as you use transitions is that they do take up time on your project, so just be mindful of that. Another thing to consider is that with video, when you place a transition at the beginning or end of a video, it may overwrite the audio somewhat, so you might wind up clipping off some of the audio. So that's a good reason to have some extra footage at the beginning or end of your videos. So let's see how these are looking so far. Now let's go to the effects transitions. Now these are kind of showy and flashy, like for example this birds one that has animated birds flying over the screen, or this very ornamental one. And you kind of want to be cautious about using those if you're not sure of. If you know your topic is more informal or it's casual, then you can probably get away with using some of these showy effect transitions. But if you want a professional presentation or a project, you may want to consider just using a standard transition or the patterns transitions, and stick to just using one or two different ones. Don't go crazy and use a whole bunch of different ones. But since this is just pictures of chickens, I think we can get away with a little bit of silliness there. And we'll go with a little bit of a J.J. Abrams lens flare for our next transition. And we'll end with some nice little theater curtains. That is how you use transitions in WeVideo. I hope you found this presentation helpful, and have a great day.